Excuse me, everyone. Good evening. I hope everyone can hear me. Welcome, members and friends. Hello, can you hear me? Hello, can you hear me? Yes. Welcome, everyone. Dear members and friends. Welcome to our annual winter dinner dance. And firstly, I wish to thank everyone of you for attending this event today. We hope you can share in the fun and fellowship during our event. This year, WASLA celebrates its 44th year of existence. We especially welcome our long-standing members who have been with WASLA and supported WASLA for many years. Thanks to our long-serving members, we have come forward a long way together. Some of you have been around and part of our association for many years, while others may have only been welcomed more recently. However, we are without a doubt especially grateful that you are all here today sharing in this special occasion as we celebrate our 44th year of existence with today's dinner dance. Today is a special day in that we honor one of our long-serving members. She is our past president, Mrs. Olga Ramasamy. She was WASLA's president during the following years, 1980 to 82, 1986 to 88, 1996 to 97, and 2007 to 2008. She served as president for a total of 6 years. This is the most by any member. More of her service will be mentioned later on. Coming to our function today, our hope is that you will enjoy the day with us and that we will strengthen the bonds and fellowship that bind us all together. May we all take the opportunity to reaffirm our friendship and fellowship towards one another. I would also like to acknowledge the contributions made by the following: Radha De Mel, Dinali David, Richard Mendes and Ellie, the Oceanite, CK Black, Natasha, De Silva, the advertisers, the committee members and their spouses, and the many others involved. Your presence here goes a long way in making this event a success. Have a great time tonight. Thank you. And now I would like to call upon Radha De Mel, to give a presentation, citation. Thank you.
Everybody, I think when you saw me putting this on the stand, you must be thinking it's going to go on for another half an hour. It's not. It is my very great privilege today to read the citation and to present this award to a woman I'm proud to call a very special role model, a mentor and friend. As most of you know, Olga was born in Sri Lanka and lived there for almost 5 decades. She bore 7 children and has 17 grandchildren and 15 great-grandchildren, which may not be a huge feat, but she is a devoted mom, grandma, and great-grandma, always at the helm of family events and ever ready to lend her love and support to all of them. Life has not always been kind to her. Tragically, she lost her daughter Nushini and grandson Steve to cancer some years ago. Losses that Olga bore with characteristic courage and stoicism. She came to Australia in 1977 with 4 young girls and immediately became actively involved in the ethnic and cultural scene by serving on the WASLA committee. Since then, she has been a passionate, ebullient, and active member of WASLA, serving as its president for over 6 years and on its executive committee for longer than anyone remembers. Apart from regularly attending and making effective contributions to the committee meetings, applying successfully for grants and sponsorships, and contributing to policy and practice, She also represented WASLA at many forums and significant events and was a very effective advocate for the Sri Lankan community. Olga threw herself into everything, as all of you know, organizing stellar events such as dances, food fairs, concerts, Christmas parties, and not just organizing, but cooking up a storm, designing and physically contributing to the decor, and often being the first one in, the last one out, including on the dance floor. I still remember one of the dances that she organized. She had been at the venue till about 6:30 or 7, went home, changed, put on this beautiful glamorous sari, had an accident on the way, and still arrived impeccably dressed and danced till about midnight. That was Olga. That is Olga. For over 20 years, she was the CEO of the Australian Asian Association, one of the largest conglomerates in the multicultural not-for-profit sector in WA. In spite of suffering pneumonia, a couple of heart attacks, and lung complications recently, she still leads the organization, sometimes from her office, sometimes from home, and even on occasion from her hospital bed. After over 2 decades of service to this organization, she has finally decided to retire at the end of this month. Not by choice, mind you, but because her doctors and the family insisted on it. However, today's felicitation is not merely about her commitment and dedication to WASLA, the Sri Lankan community, or to the greater Kord community through the Australian Association. It is not about her having celebrated her 90th birthday at the beginning of this year. Today's felicitation is to acknowledge almost 4 decades of selfless community service in Australia, and to celebrate the unique personal and professional attributes, qualifications, recognition, and accolades she has garnered along the way. Her academic qualifications are impressive. Olga has a Bachelor of Science degree, and a few years ago, at the ripe old age of 86, she graduated from Notre Dame University with a graduate certificate in not-for-profit leadership and management. The oldest student by far in WA to have achieved this qualification. And just last year, at the age of 89, she completed a postgraduate diploma in governance at Curtin University. Puts most of us to shame. Her day usually begins at 6 o'clock in the morning and ends well past 10 o'clock. She's a staunch Catholic, and attending daily mass before going to office has always been one of her life's priorities, hasn't it, Olga? In spite of working full-time all these years, Olga still managed to fit in a public or community function almost daily. Be it a wedding, funeral, cocktail party, community gathering, conference, dinner dance, one could be sure that Olga would be there. Punctual, impeccably groomed, perfectly prepared, adding glamour and interest to every function she graced. She has been on the executive committees of many significant bodies, including the National Women's Council, UN Association of Western Australia, Pan-Pacific and Southeast Asia Women's Association, and a host of other local, national, and international organizations. She has been an active member of several key governmental and non-governmental working committees and advisory groups, contributing to debates on policy and operational issues, and advocating tirelessly for a just and fair multicultural Australia, where all men and women could enjoy not just equal rights and equal opportunities, but also equal outcomes. Her efforts have been recognized nationally. It was a proud moment for Olga and the Sri Lankan community when in 1998, Olga was awarded the Order of Australia Medal. The Order of Australia, thank you. The Order of Australia, as you know, is the preeminent way Australians recognize the achievements and service of their fellow citizens. Her citation read, "To Olga Ramasamy, for service to the community, particularly through the Australian Asian Association, and to women, through the National Council of Women of Western Australia and the Pan-Pacific and Southeast Asia Women's Association." In 2001, she was awarded the Centenary Medal, a medal that acknowledges those who contributed to the success of Australia's first 100 years as a federal nation and recognizes Australians who laid solid foundations for the nation's future. The citation for the Centenary Award read, to Olga Ramasamy, for service to the community through the advancement of multiculturalism in Western Australia. Throughout her life, Olga has demonstrated a passion, energy, enthusiasm, commitment, and capacity for work that would be the envy of anyone half her age and in mint physical condition. She's brought great honor, not just to herself, but also to the Sri Lankan community and to the Australian community at large. And WASLA is indeed proud to acknowledge and celebrate her many accomplishments today. As a small token of our pride and joy, Olga, WASLA would like to present you with an exclusive crystal commemorative plaque and a small floral tribute. I would like to invite to the stage Ranjan De Silva, President of WASLA, and Vicky Sivaraja, Vice President, to make these presentations. Ranjan and Vicky. The term living legend is sometimes overused, but in this case, the most apt term I can think of. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to center stage the living legend that is Olga Ramasamy. O-A-A.
Something when you have said so many things about me. I don't know whether I'm supposed to cry.
No. No crying.
Oh, thank you all for what you have said about me. I certainly gave of my whole self from the time I joined WASLA in doing everything. And now that I have reached 90, I think my heart is refusing to do anything more. So you have to excuse me if I talk less or I cannot walk properly, because that's what I was on the sick bed for a long, long time. But I'm sorry I cannot show all the energy that I showed all the years before, doing everything that I wanted to do. Now I want to specially thank the president of WASLA, because I know how difficult it is with the WASLA committee to get consensus on doing a lot of things we would want to do.
Yeah,
so
yeah,
it was great to have got through the committee to give me this accolade. And secondly, to the entire committee and all those who are behind the organization. I know what it is, because I have been behind doing a lot of things which a lot of people may not have known about. But you need somebody to practically turn the wheels around, and then you can achieve what you wanted. So I think I'm very satisfied that during my 25 years or more here in Australia, that I have done my very best for the Sri Lankan community to the best of my ability and with whatever I could do. Now I'm losing my
energy.
I have to stop a little bit before I can say anything again.
Just rub her back.
Anyway, what can I say more than say thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Proud that the Sri Lankan community is all together now and progressing and doing what I wanted to achieve when I first came here in 1977. And I must tell you that when I first came here, my daughter in Sri Lanka told me she had a friend here, and that was Wendy Maynard. And she said, first of all, go and meet Wendy. So I went and met Wendy and never looked back since then, because she pulled me, dragged me for this, that and everything, and proposed that I become the president. And that's how I started. And that's where I went. And I encouraged as many as possible, the music people, the others, the cultural. And for 18 years, I ran the Forest Folk Fest, bringing forward all the cultural acts from about 28 different ethnic communities.
Yeah. So, well, thank you.
Thank you so much for your support for me over the last so many years. Thank you.
Yay, well done. Good speech, Olga.
From my heart.
That's good. That's the way we like it.
Can I get a photo, guys?
Photo.
Can I get a photo? One more,
brother,
one more, mom.
We get a few more pictures if anybody wants to come up. Ranjan, just ask if anybody wants to come up.
No, no. Okay, Olga, we have got a very, very special felicitation for you from an opera singer. She's a very, very famous opera singer, and she's offered to do two special songs for you. The first one is your favorite, all-time favorite song, One Day at a Time, because you do take One Day at a Time.
I assure you that I have always taken one day at a time.
And she
remember that when God gives you that day, you leave it to the best.
That's it.
And without God's blessings, I would never have been here so long.
And the second one, Olga, epitomizes your professional and personal life, because you always did it your way. So photo opportunities later on, ladies and gentlemen, but may I present professional opera singer, Dinali De Silva.
Come on, Dinali!
Oh my God! Me and my big mom. It's Dinali David. I don't know how I could have made that mistake. Please forgive me. I'm getting on in years. I'll be 60 this year. I don't Sorry, Dinali. Thank you so much.
Excuse me, I went and fell sick before today, so I'm not sure what will come out of my voice, but I'm trying.
Good, good, well done.
Doesn't work. I've had throat spray too.
Have a brandy.
That might.
More than this.
Folks, let's hear it for Dinali. And she got a fantastic voice.
Beautiful, well done, Minami.
Thank you.
Okay, so we've come to the end of our felicitation, so let's have just one more round of applause for the inimitable Olga Ramasamy.
Well done, Olga. Good job.
Congratulations, Radha De Mel.
It's a long way I have come.
You have. You still.